Sri Gurubhyo Namaha, the Bharat Scouts and Guides. Today we are going to see Fisherman Knot. So this is the picture of Fisherman Knot. In name itself you will have understood, this knot mostly used by the fishermen. So in scouting and guiding, where it is used? In camps, while making gadgets, we are using it. Normally, this knot is used by the people in those days, but nowadays, who is using? Uri katradhin solluvanga. Because if they keep things in the ground, maybe it may be eaten by rats or a cock or something. So what they will do, uri katti adhila thonga viduvanga roof la. So for that they will make this knot. And then in festivals, during the festival time, during any function, whatever the function, they will use to cook food in a big vessel. Nowadays we are using cooker, so you don't know much about that. Saadham la vellil selvanga, you know, even in some houses they will use to the saadham vadikiradhu nu solluvanga. Saadham vadikkum bodhu, if it is a very big vessel, they cannot hold it and do it. So at that time they will use this knot. The fisherman, he will carry the fishes from the fish basket from the seashore to the ground. He cannot able to carry the weight. A big basket of fishes he will bring. He cannot able to lift that basket. So at that time he will use this knot. By using this knot, he will bring the fish basket to the shore. Now I'll explain you how to make fisherman's knot. Now this fisherman knot, you have to make two ends or two ropes. You can take, you have to hold like this. Now already I said thumb knot. Thumb knot is a simple knot. Now you are making this, and one end you have to bring it from, this should be inside this. Now you are making a thumb knot here in one corner and leave it. The other corner again you are bring it inside, see inside, and then you are making the thumb knot. You are doing thumb knot. Now you can see this. Now whether you have done correctly or not, if you pull and see the, it is moving. So how they used to carry the basket with the help of these knots means, now I'll show you a water bowl. During the camp, while you are going for an outing, while you are going for hike and trekking, you can use this knot to carry your water bottles. Some water bottles, a rope will be there, you can hang it. But in some water bottles, see the water bottles like this, you cannot hold it in a hand for a longer distance and can able to walk. So at the time you can make use of this knot. See this knot, the water bottle, and you can pull both the sides. Both the sides, and now you can hang it on your shoulder and you can walk freely. Nothing is in your hand, now you can walk freely. See, now the water bottle is hanged. Like the same way, the basket or whatever things, see here, you can extend it. If it is a basket, they will put inside the basket and they will tighten it and they will lift it. Okay, now once again I'm showing you how to make. This is fisherman knot, mostly used by the fishermen. So it is called as a fisherman knot. It can be used by one rope as well as in two ropes also we can use it. Now I am doing it with one rope. See, you are doing like this, two sides. Now leave it one side, the other side, hold like this. This is the end of the rope. Bring it inside. See, now this should be the end of the rope. Now you make a thumb knot in the corner, and the other side you hold it. See here, this should be inside, and you make a thumb knot here. Thumb knot is an ordinary knot. You can now, if you pull both the sides, it is moving. See, so whether it is a small size basket or a bigger one or a water bottle, whatever it is. Now I am using here water bottle, and I am tightening this. See the water bottle. In camp, the children, you can make use of this knot, and you can hang things in the tent, because in tent, you know very well, you all need space to sleep during the night time. So you cannot keep your luggages very nearby, and the water bottle and whatever things, not only the water bottle, whatever things, you can hang it like this, and you can hang it in the tent. Now when you go for outing, you can hang this in your shoulder. See, now I am hanging in my shoulder, and I will walk freely when I go for a hike or for a trekking, whatever it is. So the water bottle is hanged in my shoulder. So clear, children? Yeah. Children, practice these knots and make use of it. These knots not only you are using in campsites, as well as at home also, for various purpose you can use these knots. Many are using these knots, but they don't know the names, what knot they are using. And the difference between the knots which is used by the scouts and guides and by the common people is find out easily. We can easily able to find out, because the knots which is made by the scouts and guides will be neat work, and where which knot is necessary, that knot will be used by the scouts and guides. But the common people, whatever knots they like, they use in other whatever places, they will use different types of knots. So children, practice all these knots. Now totally how many knots we have seen? How many basic knots are there? There are 6 basic knots are there. The first one is the reef knot, sheet bend, sheaf shank, clove hitch, bowline, and fisherman knot. Are you clear, children? Practice. Practice makes a man perfect. If you practice, you can do it easily. Thank you. Please press the subscribe button, and you will receive the latest updates. Thank you.